NBC News. This is Today with Kathy Lee Gifford and Hoda Kotb from Studio 1A in Rockefeller Plaza.
And baby, it's cold outside, but cheer up. We're going to tell you how to reverse those winter blues and stir up some excitement.
Oh, I can't wait.
Right after this.
Okay.
You're going to have as stressful as the holiday season might be, and I'm still not over it, it gives us something to focus on and to celebrate.
And then January comes, and after all that prepping and shopping and cleaning and cooking and partying,
and children,
boom, there's nothing to plan for.
Between that and long, dark days,
dark, depressed
and
right
long,
now.
It's no wonder many of us aren't fans of this time of the year. Here to help turn those winter blues into a season of cheer, really, is psychiatrist Mary Ann Chai. Am I pronouncing it right?
Absolutely right.
And she's medical director of New York Center for Living. Welcome for the
Thank
first time
you
on
very
our
much.
Show.
You
nice
know what's
to see
interesting?
You,
you hear anecdotally about people who suffer from this, but we did a Today.com survey, and our results said that 82% said yes, they are affected by this type of year. Only 18% said
Absolutely.
No. This is, we're talking about a scientific thing.
This is talking about a chemical thing.
Well, there are a lot of factors that can contribute. You hit the nail on the head when you said the darker, colder days of winter, longer days of winters. And these are record-breakingly cold
and
days
we're having, days of sunshine.
And shorter days of sunshine. So there's different phenomena going on. There's serious depression some people struggle with. It's maybe less seasonal. There's seasonal affect disorder.
Right. Which I have in spades.
Right. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And then not surprisingly, so many people, particularly now, are saying, yes, I am feeling blue. I'm feeling the post-holiday
Well, we started
depression.
Saying that you need something to look forward to. Sometimes
yes.
look forward to Christmas, you look forward to New Year's, and then after that there's this long lull where there's
no Groundhog's Day.
Yeah, there's nothing going on. Is that part of it? We
that
don't have anything
absolutely
to look
part
to?
Of it. And there's also like more isolation after the holidays. So you've got this blitzkrieg of holidays going from October through early January, and a lot of people are really connected face to face, and then they lose that. So it's really important to plan to be around people, to incorporate activities and things you can look forward to where you are connecting real time face to face with people rather
like Super
than
Super Bowl.
Super Bowl, Valentine's Day, or even simple things like starting a book club, having dinner parties once a month or even every few weeks, planning little trips maybe to places you wouldn't normally go with your friends. Really great ways to stay connected and have something to look forward to.
I found that something just as simple as putting fresh flowers in your house can just lift your spirits.
Sometimes like it's little things. Like
so this is the other really important thing. On a day-to-day basis, what can you do to brighten that day, to bring the gloom of the outside not into your home?
What can we do, doctor?
Oh, so many things. I think when it's
You're the psychiatrist.
I am the psychiatrist. I think a hot bath is a great thing to do. So good for the joints. It's warming of the soul. It gives you kind of a moment to treat yourself. It doesn't cost a whole lot of money. It's a simple activity. Sometimes just making yourself a nice cup of hot tea and giving yourself that moment to step back and just say, this is where I am.
Sometimes
this is what
people,
I'm doing.
I think, just need to pay attention to someone who has it worse than they do. I always feel whenever I'm in a funk, and literally you could walk by someone on the street and you go, oh my God, like it reminds you, kind of stop the whining portion of the program.
Perspective.
Yeah.
A whole lot of perspective, because we lose that.
Uh-huh. Is some of it all wrapped up in all the expectation people have about the holidays? Why do we set ourselves up for failure like that? This is going to be the best Christmas ever.
Best
oh,
New
I can't
Year's
wait till
Eve.
New Year's Eve. I'm going to, and then it's never what we concoct in our mind it to be, is it?
Anticipation and expectations can like save you or kill you in this world. And so a lot of it is about the attitude and post-holidays, just forgive yourself. It's okay. Maybe it didn't work out the way you wanted it to, but there's always the next holiday, and what can you do to make things a little bit better right now?
I just want to know, is there any more room on your couch? Because I like you.
The
you made us feel
couch.
So much better.
I do feel better.
I don't feel the blues anymore.
Me either.
I feel the yellows.
All right, we're going to show you coming up.
Lovely
thanks, sweetie.
You.
We're going to show you the best app.